गुड मॉर्निंग एंड वेलकम बैक टू आवर सेशंस ऑन द क्रिप्टोग्राफी एंड स्पेशली रिलेटेड टू द की मैनेजमेंट एंड डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. इन दिस सेशन आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द सेशन कीज लाइफ टाइम. इन द प्रीवियस डिस्कशंस वी हैव सीन द टू इम्पॉर्टेंट कीज दैट आर यूज इन द एनक्रिप्शन. वन इज द मास्टर की which is denoted by K subscript M, and the second one is the session key which is denoted by K subscript S. There itself we have discussed that session keys are temporary in nature and we need to exchange or we need to change these session keys every now and then. This particular requirement of changing the session key every now and then is to make the attacker learn a few things, very little things he can know even though the session key is compromised, right. So for this purpose we have suggested, the author has suggested, that the session keys has to be changed every now and then. But there is no idea on what should be the lifetime of these session keys. We are not bothered about this master key, forget about this. And we are only concentrating on the lifetime of this session keys, when it should start its life or when it the life of the session key has to be ended. This particular topic we have not discussed. So this session is a very simple and very small topic which discusses about the lifetime of the session keys. Coming to the session keys, we know that these session keys are the keys which are going to be frequently exchanged. We have seen in the previous discussions also. And when you secure these session keys in a manner such that the opponent has very less ciphertext to work on it or to do some crypt analysis on the ciphertext, we need to secure these session keys. And one important requirement such that the opponent has less ciphertext to work with is you have to concentrate on the lifetime of the session keys. But before this, we'll discuss it with examples also, how it is going to happen in the connection oriented protocols and how it is going to happen with the connectionless protocols. All these things we'll discuss, very simple topic. But before this, let us have a discussion on what are the disadvantages we have with the distribution of these session keys. The first disadvantage we have with this distribution of session keys is it is going to delay the actual exchange of information that takes place between the entities, right. For example, you take two parties A and B. The secure channel. And we can see from the previous discussions or from the previous diagrams what we have discussed, that before the actual communication is going to happen between these two parties, they need to have some idea on the session key. They need to request the KDC to send the KS or the session key, and after receiving the KS they can communicate it. So, before transmitting or exchange of the actual information, you have to do lot of work to generate the session key or to request the session key, to generate the session key, to receive the session key, everything, lot of burden is there before doing the actual exchange of data. What happens with this extra load means it is going to burden on the network capacity. It is going to put lot of burden on this network capacity. Why? Because you have to do lot of processing before transmitting the actual data. You need to work a lot on the KS or the session keys. So it will put or it will reduce the network capacity or it will reduce the efficiency of the network capacity or it we can simply say that it will simply burden the network capacity. And of course, we have a role which is called as the security manager who always try to balance these competing considerations by determining the lifetime of a particular session key. Here plays the very important role of the lifetime of the session key. So, the security manager, he will decide what should be the life of a session key. For this explanation, I will take two simple examples. One is the connection oriented and the second one is the connectionless. Let us go with the connection oriented protocols. We know that the connection oriented protocols are something like TCP and the connectionless are UDPs like this. In the connection oriented protocols, it is obvious that we need to create a connection before transmitting the actual data. So, connection establishment is the first step between these two communicating parties in the connection oriented scenario. So, in such cases, the use of the same session key for the length of the time that the connection is open is one choice. So, what is choice one? We have, you can take the session key at the time the connection is established and you can just leave that session key or kill that session key once the connection is revoked. So, the point here you have to understand is the choice one for the session key, that means the life of the session key should be the length of the connection. Length in the sense it is not the physical length which is measured in meters, it is the life of the connection. So, how many seconds or how many milliseconds or how many minutes it is going to the connection is going to live, that is called as the length of the connection. So, the life of the session key is directly related to the life of the connection. And once the connection is over, you can simply discard this KS and you can go for another session key for the new session. For example, and remember that the life of the session key cannot be too long or cannot be too large. Why? Means we have discussed that reason. So, if the life of the session key is kept so shorter, then whatever information that the attacker gets, whatever ciphertext that the attacker gets, he may not get the required information. Or he may not get all the information that is sent from the sender to the receiver. So, in order to protect the communication that happens between the sender and the receiver, or in order to protect the communication from the third party attacker, from the crypt analysis attacks or so many attacks to happen, we are going to limit the session key. So, whenever it is limited, the session key is limited, then you have very, the attacker will have very less information, which by using that particular limited information, he cannot get any necessary output. So, for this reason, we are going to put the life of the session key as low as possible. So, in the connection oriented protocol, the choice one you have to taken is the session key life is related to the life of the connection. But what happens? If the connection of the length of the connection or the life of the connection is too large, I told that the length of the life of the session key is dependent on life of connection. But what is if what happens if the life of connection is too large? in such case what you will do is you will not restrict the session key life to be equal to the life of the connection. So we can periodically, we can arrange a timer. This is choice 2. We can arrange a timer for this session key, and once the timer is over, the session key will be revoked and the new session key is generated for the next time period, right? Or else you can also make a choice like this, that every time the PDU is nothing but the protocol data unit, the data unit simply you can solve, right? So every time the data unit sequence number cycles at that particular time, you can discard the previous session key and you can create the new session key, right? So these are the three choices we have under this connection oriented. The choice one is the length or the life of the session key is equal to the life of the connection, but if it is so large, we have other two choices. One is you can arrange a timer for this session key, and once the timer is expired, discard the session key and go for new session key. The third choice is you can go with the length of the data unit or the sequence number of the data unit. Once the sequence number means cycling means the sequence number starts from 1 to 99, assume that, and after this again it will cycle to 1. So from 1 to 99 you can make use of one single key, and whenever it cycles you make use of another session key, whenever there is another cycle you make use of the third session key. Like this you can make this choice also. Now let us discuss what happens in the connectionless scenarios. In the connectionless scenario, we are not going to establish a connection between the two entities. No connection is there. It is wireless communication. Don't assume that it is completely wireless, but we say that it is a connectionless protocol. Why? Because one best example for this connectionless protocol is transaction oriented protocol. So here the transmission of data from one entity to another entity is going to be limited based upon the life of the transaction. Very short transactions. The transaction itself is very short. So whenever you have the session key to be used for this particular transaction oriented protocols, you just make it a thing like the session key is related to the life of the transaction. Very simple thing. Remember that since it is connectionless, it is not going to make use of any explicit connection initiation or termination, but when it is connection oriented, as I told that before exchanging the actual data, you need to establish a connection, and after the actual data is exchanged, once you want to terminate it, you have to terminate the connection. But the connection establishment and the connection termination is not required in the connectionless protocols. So for this type of connectionless transactions or connectionless protocols that we are going to use during the communication, we cannot decide on the need of when we can change the session key. What is the lifetime of the session key? That is not clearly described. And one approach or one choice we have under this connectionless protocol is we can use a new session key for each exchange. So for each and every transaction you make use of a single session key. So every transaction one session key, very simple approach, right? This is the only choice we have under this connectionless protocol. Or else you can also for every transaction, instead of every transaction, you can make use of the session keys for a group of transactions or for a certain number of transactions. For example, let us limit that the session key is for the 3 transactions. So, after first 3 transactions, the KS1 is removed, and for the next 3 transactions, we are going to make use of the next session key. And if it is over, remove it or discard it, and you create a new session key 3, and you use this new session key for the coming 3 transactions. This is an example, right. So, the session key can be linked to every transaction, or the session key can be linked to a period, limited number of transactions. So, that is all about the session key lifetime. Let us see what the other is saying, right. So, the more frequently session keys are exchanged, we know this one, and the more secure they are, because the opponent has less ciphertext to work with for any given session key. The distribution of session keys delays the start of any exchange. I told this one, right. Before the actual exchange of data, we need to do some work related to the session keys. So, that is going to burden on the network capacity, but the security manager can try to balance these things by determining the lifetime of a particular session key. We have seen it in case of connection oriented protocols and the connectionless protocols, right. In the connection oriented protocol, we have 3 choices. The first choice can be the KS lifetime is equal to the lifetime of the connection, and or else you can put a timer for this KS, and after the timer is expired, discard that KS, go for the new KS, or else you can have the session key until unless you have the data units sequence is cycled. In the connectionless protocol, since we do not have any connection establishment and termination, you can go for 2 choices, that every transaction you make use of 1 session key. And the second choice is you can club more than 1 sessions and 1 transaction, and you can use 1 session key for the different or the set of transactions. This is all about the session key lifetime. Thank you one and all for joining the session.